Hi simulation friends, it is time to fly again. Finally, after quite some time, we are flying in X-Plane 11, a full flight video again, while not live streaming. And we are going to fly southwest, this time the Boeing 737-700 Ultimate by Zeebo, from Burbank Airport in Los Angeles, Kilo Bravo Uniform Romeo, to Sacramento International Airport, Kilo Sierra Mike Foxtrot. And as you can see right here in X-Plane 1140 Release Candidate 1, so 1140 isn't fully released yet, we are standing right here at Gate A2 in Burbank, during a beautiful sunrise mood right here in Los Angeles. So we have Active Sky XP running, providing the real-world weather. We have the Ground Handling Deluxe plugin by JAR Design connected to the aircraft. And as I said already, we are flying the most up-to-date version of the Zeebo Boeing 737-700 Ultimate. So not the 800X this time, but the little brother of it, in version 337 Update 9. So the newest version 337 has just been released some days ago, and we are going to check out some of the newest features that it offers. As you can see, we have a beautiful add-on freeware scenery for Burbank, and also for Sacramento we will have some amazing freeware scenery, and you can find all the mods that I'm using and also the links to these freeware sceneries in the video description. And now we are inside the aircraft, and it's actually the first time we are flying the 737-700 Ultimate version. Also, Mr. Zeebo is now officially updating all of these Boeing freeware airplanes for X-Plane 11 at the same time, it seems. So the 737-800X, the 700 Ultimate and the 900 Ultimate versions are all at the same version status right now. They are all 337 Update 9. And by now you can get all these updates for all the aircraft from his Google Drive page. So this is very convenient as well. And we are in the cockpit. The initial power-up has been completed already. Electrical power is established and the ground power is connected. Also the IRSs should be aligned by now. And we are going to have a quick look at the new settings in the AVTEP, or the electronic flight bag of this aircraft. So let us start with the new failures options that are available. You can now fail some systems if you like to. I don't think there's a wear and tear system implemented yet, so I think right now you can only manually fail systems if you like. And also fix them again. We also have some new ground service options available. As you can see, the GPU is not connected and we still have ground power available, as you can see. And this has to do with a new option that simulates a ground power cable from the ground. That comes from the stand of the airport, so that you don't necessarily need this external GPU anymore. We have the new air stairs, and these have been implemented in 336 already, I think. And the fuel truck option as well, that's relatively new. And we need to click this button to get the fuel that we have loaded in the weight and balance tool, to get it actually filled into the aircraft. I will show you that in a second as well. Now let's go to the options pages, and I have to see right here what is new. And I think from the multi-mode receiver downwards everything should be new. The aspirated TAT probe is relatively new, and also these radio callout settings are brand new in version 337. So all these altitude callouts can now be enabled or disabled to your liking. We also have a new white bug for V2 plus 20 or 15, you can choose that. And right here we have the new ground power cable connection that replaces the GPU, if you like. And this setting will change the behavior of the GPU connection when arriving at the airport and the gate. On the hardware configuration page we have a new setting for the XHSI, if you have that. I don't know exactly what it is, it must be some add-on horizontal situation indicator of some kind. Maybe software or hardware, I don't know. On the realism settings page you have this new FMC input lag setting. If you like to have a little less responsive FMC, you can enable that. And I think that was it for the new settings that are available via the electronic flight bag for the Zeebo. So now let's get to the fuel weight and balance management. And we are going to load our aircraft for today's flight. So as usual you have to enter the payload value to get to our desired zero fuel weight. Our zero fuel weight will be 117.7 and fuel will be 13.1. And now as you can see, we have a fuel requested value that I just entered and the actual fuel that is loaded into the aircraft at the moment. And to actually refuel the aircraft now, we have to go to the ground services tab and then fuel truck call. And this will now change our loaded fuel and as you can see at a relatively realistic rate. In the realism settings you also have the option to load the fuel more quickly. The AVTAP pages are working as usual, nothing has changed here. Right here you can see our airport diagram for Burbank Airport. And we are going to depart runway 26, we are parking right here. And it's also a very short runway. So I guess we are departing with flaps 10 today. And right there you can see an actual fuel truck model. That is now part of the Zeebo, it seems, I didn't see it before. So this fuel truck, the hose, this guy and also the ladder, that all seems to be part of the external model of the Zeebo now, it seems. So the improvements and new features that you get via the new updates are really nice in my opinion. Not only under the hood, the technical stuff, but also visual goodies like these. So now let us quickly deal with the FMC. I already filled out the initialization page. And we are flying from Burbank Kilo Bravo Uniform Romeo to Sacramento International, near to San Francisco. And the identifier is Kilo Sierra Mike Foxtrot. And again we are reenacting a real-world flight and the flight number is Southwest 346. So going to our departure page, we are planning to depart 26 via the OROS 2 SIT to Castro. Then we fly to Newray, N-U-R-A-Y. And this is already where our star begins, quite a short flight today. So we are planning to land at Sacramento via the ILS 34 left, because there are winds from the north at the moment. And the Suter 2 arrival from Newray, and let's try the SAC transition. So that's looking nice and we can activate and execute. The wind will come from 302 at 34 knots and ISA deviation 5. And that's nice. N1 limit page. And we are not going to derate this time because the runway is very short. So we'll leave it like this. And choosing flaps 10 today. CG is okay. And V-speeds as well. So let us now quickly check our flight route and also some charts. So the OROS 2 departure tells us to fly heading 290 after takeoff from runway 26 and then getting vectors towards Tiller. And then OROS and then flying this way up to Castro. So we step through the plan and check if everything's correct. There we have Tiller and OROS and then flying towards Castro, that's looking nice. So that's all looking nice now.
Hey Lily, Sheldon for the flight deck. Welcome aboard. You're gonna be on the way shortly for the first leg. These three wonderful flight attendants, give them your attention as we push a taxi. They're gonna give you plenty of attention and route. Enjoy the flight. We'll talk to you
later. So the APU is started. Let's connect the gens. We don't have ATC today as Sacramento Airport isn't supported by XLive. So I dial in an initial climb altitude of 230. Departure heading will be 259 for the first few seconds before we turn right to 290, and V2 plus 20 will be 160. So flight director's on.
The overwing window exits designated at emergency exit row. If you're seated in this row, please refer to the safety information.
Let us set up some squawk. Squawking altitude. And the MCP is set, let's arm heading select. Before calling better pushback, let us tune into ATIS. We could have done this a bit earlier already. And let's use the Active Sky XP ATIS.
Kilo Bravo Uniform Romeo Airport Information Juliet 1453 Zulu weather wind calm visibility 10 sky clear temperature 11 2.6 altimeter 3008 advise on initial contact that you have information Juliet.
So there seems to be no wind, and we have our altimeter setting. And we are ready to push, so let us release the parking brake.
Starting pushback, and you may start engines.
So for engine start, let us turn off the PEX. Let's start the right engine first.
Approaching 2-6.
And you could already hear the runway awareness and advisory system because we are very close to the runway right here at Burbank. And as the tow is disconnecting, let us start the left engine. Departing with flaps 10 this time. And let's also set our trim to 3.3. Quite forward this time. So now we should be ready to taxi. Let's go. The way to our active runway 26 is extremely short. And we should finally be ready for departure, out of Burbank. The overhead looks fine, lights are all set. MCP is set, RTO and flaps are set. Transponder TARA, and we also have the weather and terrain radars enabled. So now let us assume that we have takeoff clearance from runway 26, cleared to climb to flight level 230, and expecting flight level 300, our cruise altitude, within 10 minutes as usual. So let's try to take as much runway as we can, as the runway is very short, as I said already. So let's see how this works out.
On runway 26.
Runway heading will be 259, and this looks amazing, I must say. So everything seems to be set. So let us increase power, brakes off, and toga. Not checked.
V1 rotate.
And you can see the runway is already ending. Gear up. Initially about 20 degrees. 400 feet. Heading select is checked. Our lateral navigation mode.
1,000.
And at 1,000 feet, let's turn right and increase speed to flaps up speed. We don't have any speed restrictions, so let's go up to 250 knots. And autopilot on. And now let's go direct to tiller. Inserting it. And VNF, LNF, please. Auto brake off as well. And the surroundings right here around Los Angeles look absolutely beautiful with Ortho4XP textures. And we are climbing like a rocket pretty much. 3 degrees Celsius, so let's engage our anti-ice and also turn off our landing lights, runway turn-off lights, engine anti-ice on. And so far so good, we have passed our transition altitude, 180, standard barrels. And now we have reached 230 at Heyo waypoint. So let's assume we have been cleared to our cruise flight level 300. And now, after the cruise phase, the descent is coming up. Let's dial in 210 as our first descent altitude. And the aircraft should start the descent shortly. As you can see, we have several altitude restrictions on during this star. So let's see how the Zeebo behaves during this descent. And there we go, the descent path is coming down, and we start our descent in VNF mode. Throttles back to idle. And now during descent the plane tries to keep 270 knots. We have the altitude restrictions as well. And the calculated descent path really seems to fit, until fools, at least. 210 right there, that's the calculation. And after that we go 12,000, or between 19 and 12,000. And then 9,000 above, so we'll see which descent altitude to set next. Now let's dial in 19,000 for the next restriction to see how it works. Okay, right there we seem to have a step descent of some kind. Right there we have the next descent point from flight level 210 and then going down again, so for now we are leveling off. Maybe the plane does that so we can have another descent without interruptions after this point to match all these altitude constraints. I'm not completely into the Boeing logic right there, but that might be the reason. We can also have a look at some approach charts for our arrival airport, Kilo Sierra Mike Foxtrot. The arrival will be Suter 2. And there we can also see the all the altitude and speed restrictions. We also have some 8 to 80 knots restrictions right here, but the plane keeps on descending at 270 knots. But that's fine for me. And we are planning to approach via the ILS runway 34 left. So coming from down here and then at LMAC, we should be at 3400 feet. Descending further to 1400 feet and then intercepting the ILS. That's our plan. ILS frequency 111.1, course 348. Let's double check with our approach ref page. And we are planning to land flaps 30, because the runways are long. We can also set up some distance fixes around the airport for visual guidance. So Kilo Sierra Mike Foxtrot. And then setting up a radius around the airport at distance 11 and distance 4 approximately. And now we seem to have a descent problem again. The aircraft keeps on slowing down and then accelerating again. That's a problem I have experienced in the past already. I don't know what's happening there. So let's see how the VNAV will behave further down the road. I'm going to set the NAV radios already, so 111.1. And the course right here in X-Plane is 347, it seems. And we continue our descent. So sometimes the aircraft is leveling off, I don't know why. And we can also tune into our arrival ATIS.
Kilo Sierra Mike Foxtrot, airport information, Quebec 1553, Zulu weather, wind 3-2-7 at 9, visibility 1-0, sky clear, temperature 8,
altimeter
dew point
setting.
Minus 1-2, altimeter 3-0-1-7, advise on initial contact that you have information, Quebec. kilos.
Okay, so we have winds from the north at 9 knots. Another nice feature that came in one of the last updates is that you can preset your altimeter before switching it from standard. So you can see what is set prior to disengaging the standard altimeter. And it's 3017 for our arrival into Sacramento. The wind is constant at 9 knots, so wind correction of 5 knots is okay. Adding that to 139. Now we are decelerating to 240 knots as we have a speed restriction at minor. So that's all working out quite nicely. Still descending in LNAV and VNAV mode. And again getting a bit too fast. And we can now switch on our fixed landing lights. We still have 0 degrees, so engine anti-ice stays on. So the speed brakes are extended and we have problems to slow down. Maybe we'll come in a bit hot and fast, we'll see. We can now also switch on our retractable landing lights for some more drag maybe. And now we have passed the deceleration point. Now the aircraft will decelerate to flaps up speed. Also right here around Sacramento we have beautiful ortho 4 XP photo rear ground textures. And now I'm going to deploy flaps 2. And now we are descending to 1400, setting our final approach heading 347. And flaps 5, speed brakes come in and also arm them. And now we should be descending towards 1400 feet. And then at the Hetzu waypoint we will intercept the ILS. So I guess we can go VOR lock already. So now we are nicely approaching our ILS intercept point.
2500.
We can go flaps 10 by now.
Thousand to go.
And we don't need to descend that fast. Trying to dial in the calculated point to match this waypoint. Our ILS intercept, if you know what I mean. Now let's go gear down and flaps 15. Our final approach speed will be 144. And setting flaps 30, all the lights on. And arming the approach mode. I forgot to set the minimums as usual. There are 292 in this case, I think. Okay, and now I'm going to take over and land this aircraft. Our missed approach altitude will be 2000. And autopilot and auto throttle off.
1000 feet stabilized, missed approach altitude set.
Forgot to resync the throttles, that's why they were in idle for a very short moment.
Approaching 3-4 left.
Getting a tad too fast.
300 minimums.
And the landing wasn't perfect, but at least relatively smooth. We took a bit too much off the runway. Speed brakes in and flaps as well. And now we need to take the whole runway before we can exit. And there we are, welcome to Sacramento Airport. And right there we have our gates. We are going to join these southwest planes and then we'll have a look at the replays. So let's take this gate. I think it's B22. And we have our autogate marshaller present. And there we are, parking brake. And we can release the passengers. APU gens on, APU bleed as well. And now we can shut down the engines and I hope that the replay will still work. And now I will try to fire up the replays. And as expected, there are several issues with the replays after the plane has been shut down. There are problems with the sounds and also some of the lights. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this flight from Burbank to Sacramento. For me it was quite a lot of fun, and the plane also behaved well for the most part with the newest update. So again, I hope you liked this flight. If you did, then please leave a thumbs up, tell me what you think in the comments, and also subscribe if you like. So have a great day everybody, and until next time, see ya!